We are here for Triple M. That is our main focus. So what does Triple M stands for? Because as much as we are Christians, we are being attacked by, when you introduce someone and you say it's Triple M and they tell you, hey, that's devil. It's not devil. It just means it's Mavrodi Mondial Movement. Mavrodi being the guy here in front of me. Being the guy here that started the movement, and then Mondial meaning we are worldwide, and the movement it means we are moving. Because as you can see, I can introduce you today, but you always feel the need of introducing someone. So that is a green movement. That's how I call it. I just call it green movement. So that is where we are, and just it means as much as it is. It was started by the guy, but it's not him. We are the system. We are Triple M. He's just a person that came with an idea, and then we took it over. We are the system. Do we understand? So yes, MMM is just a technical system that is used to control. If I would say this is MMM, and then I am here, and then the sister is on the other side. If I've got the willingness of wanting to put money in the system, this is MMM. I'm just gonna use this one, this tool, to communicate with her. That, hey, my sister, I'm gonna send you money. And then what she's gonna say, okay, I am willing to have your money. Because when you provide help, you must provide it to someone. And then that someone must be willing to what? To receive your help. So that is what Triple M, there's no money there, it's just a system. The money is with me and her. You understand? So yes, that is why we call it a central system that we are using just to control the participants, just to control the movement. There is no money in the system. That's one thing that we have to understand. Right now, as whatever that is going on, that thing that you see there, it's just numbers. There's no money there. It needs us to still what? Make it move. So yes, and it does not have what? The central banking where we will say, we have all put our 100 rands there. Oh. At the end of the day, this bank must share amongst us. There's nothing like it. We don't have a central banking. And then we just call it a social networking, because here I am today. If I was not here, you wouldn't have known me. He wouldn't have known me. So that is why we call it a social networking, because at the end of the day, after all the money has been involved, they should be socializing. Like today at Joburg, there is a rally. People are meeting each other there. That's socializing. We've got people, I've got downlines at Swaziland, downlines Uganda. You see, we're socializing. Because those people, they know, okay, there is someone like that. And I always know, okay, there is someone there. So that is social networking. For as much as we deal with money, it's still socializing in a way. So yes, the guy has just introduced one of the most wonderful systems that is taking us to a better level. And then, when did the system start? Yes, there have been other Triple M's before. That happened. We won't discuss things that never happened here in South Africa. So, but there's been other Triple M's that the guys started, but they couldn't sustain themselves. So in 2011, he reworked this system. And then he looked at the mechanism that is gonna benefit you and benefit me and benefit, I mean, the ideology of Triple M does not say, I have to benefit myself. It says we have to grow, you understand? By me recruiting myself and just staying with Triple M and not telling anyone, who am I freeing? If we call this a financial liberation, who are we liberating? No one, we understand that. So yes, that is why the ideology, it's talking about spreading Triple M. And in South Africa, unfortunately, the state says we're 54 million and it's only 2 million participants. Therefore, work still needs to be done. This call, we don't need to hire it next time. Yes. If you take your money to the bank, who is it helping?
No one,
except the bank. I call them registered criminals. But yes, it only helps the bank, because if I were to take my money like now and deposit it to my bank account, come 30 days, if I put in 10,000 now, will I get 10,000?
No,
I won't get it. It will be 9,000 something. Mm-hmm. There is a rent that I've paid. Mm-hmm. There is this and this and that. But if you participate in the system, do you lose anything? Mm-hmm.
No, even we are going through a restart. Has anyone lost anything? It's just your money is the way it is until the time we reach the panic.
Whenever you get paid, it's still gonna be there. You won't lose the rent because then your money's frozen now. And then it just says financial order as a wealth mutual fund aid community primarily to free the people from bondage or financial slavery. Do you know how weighing down a credit can be? Like if you have access to buying a car via a bank or a house, they add money on you. Didn't ask them to call you, but that adds money to you. They send you a letter to tell you, will you pay us this much, now you are owing this much. They still charge you for that. Did you ask them to do that? No, that is financial slavery because you are being a slave. You understand? In the apartheid time, slavery was another way, but now slavery is dead. True, slavery is dead. Because what, for as much as we don't want to put it into our children's head, but it's true. When your child grows up, you're only telling them what? You go through school, you go through university, and then you get a job. And then when that child gets a job, already he owes student loan. And then, okay, fine, he will try and make means and make an arrangement. He starts to work. And then you make arrangements how to pay this. Then the second month, what does he want? A contract form. And then the second month he wants clothing. He cannot buy them cash. He cannot afford them. But because he's got this pay slip, and then he thinks he can afford. But he cannot. So that is debt and being a slave to debt. So this system is working so hard to take us out of debt. It's just that, unfortunately, not everyone understands. So the guy started Triple M, and then he's a programmer. Meaning whatever that is going through the system, as the programmers, they will go via him because he knows what is going on. So it means they cannot, whenever the programmers think of something, he's always 10 steps ahead of them. He's a mathematician. That is why he can always miss the numbers. He can tell you. That's why most of the people were in 100%. When things were not, the math was not adding up, it was easy for him to tell them, hey guys, this is not working out. Because at the end of the day, what was going to happen? People were going to lose money. But instead, he ruined it. Using his mathematician, we know most mathematicians, they don't see it. Unfortunately, I'm not very good. But yes, and then he's worked in the government as well, where if you read his history, he didn't even accept his pay. When they wanted to give him pay, he would take the money and then give it to other people. That's how he is, the guy himself. So on this slide, it's one of that thing I just told you about, that this is just the technical basic program which helped millions of participants worldwide to found those who are in need. On our system, we are using a currency called Mavro. We're calling it Mavro because the guy, his name is Mavrodi, and therefore we cannot say it's rent because we are in his state. We are in his territory. So he decided to call it Mavros, meaning whenever you buy a dream, you buy a dream using your rent. And then when someone confirms you that you have provided your help to, it's confirmed, it will be your PO, your personal office, will be credited with Mavros. We understand. And the Mavros are just that, Mavros, just numbers, as I was mentioning. And then when you want now, after 30 days, you want that money now, back to you. What do? You sell those marbles that you bought with your rent. You sell them after you have sold them. Someone who's willing to buy them, that's what? Pay money to your bank account. That is where this money now. We understand. When it's there, it's marbles. So if you were to withdraw marbles, what would you do with marbles? Do you even know what is the value of marbles? You don't know. This answers mostly the question that a lot of people have when you recruit them to Triple M and then you tell them about this 30%, and then they ask you, if you say this system does not have money now, where am I getting that 130 if I put 100 rand? It's easy. It's crowdfunding. If all of us here are employed, maybe by one company, we are paid 10,000, all of us. The company will pay to the bank name.
And then what happens if all of us, the following day, goes and withdraw? Will we all get our 10,000? No, we won't get our 10,000. We can only get our 10,000 if we were paid yesterday and then another company is paying today, but the red tape is gonna be released tomorrow. You understand? So meaning whatever the 10,000 that your company paid to the bank, you're not getting it. So in this system, whenever you buy your Mavros, you buy your 100 Mavros. And then the system, as the warning says, the next day you might wake up, it's you to say zero. Because that is that. It's just Mavros. And then you have bought your Mavros for 100 rand. And then every day you are allocated a percent. That is just Mavros. And then when those Mavros, they reach 180 now, you have to withdraw. Who's going to give you? It's a crowd. It's people. They're going to say, this one has 100 rand. He can pay you. This one wants to buy Mavros for 30 rand, then they can pay. Then they combine these people, and then these two people, they pay you alone. That is crowdfunding. That is how the bank manages itself. It's just that, unfortunately, the bank will use your money, but they won't reward you for it. Instead, they'll save you all the money. But yes, it's crowdfunding. Even if you have put 1,000 rand for 2,000, whenever you want that 2,000 now, that the system tells you you have, you will just tell the system, I want now these 2,000 Mavros, and then it's processed. Whenever it's processed, it's going to choose people who want to put exactly those amounts, not more, because you want 2,000 now. Exactly the money that this person declared that he wanted to willingly donate. That is what we must understand again. As you say, this is a donation exchange. We are willingly donating to each other. We understand it. You cannot tomorrow phone me because you deposited me 10,000 the other day and say now you want your money. With donation. Do you want your donation back? You cannot claim a donation. So this system, as it says, is a donation exchange. You are willingly. No one forces anyone. Unless someone was forced here to join. But no one is forced to join Triple M. And then we at a stage where we ask people not to convince people to join Triple M. Do not convince a person to join Triple M. Give the person the information about Triple M and then tell them to go and research it themselves. Mm. And then they must join up. Because all of these things that are happening now, we get people wanting their money as if they deposited their money to you. Unfortunately, they didn't. Even if you had, but when you bought a dream, they chose me for you to deposit to me. That was my money. You willingly donated to me. I cannot give it to you. I don't owe you. We understand that. It's like even if you had joined Triple M, maybe wanting to get rid of your friend, and then your order comes now, you no longer want to pay. No one has to force you because you don't owe that person. If you no longer want to participate, you just don't. We understand that. That is why it's important to participate with spare money. Do not put your life savings on Triple M. Whenever you join Triple M, participate with spare money. All the time. That should be understood very clear. And then the following slide, it's just telling us, now here is Patricia, has given you what is Triple M, has told you it's a donation exchange. Whatever we participate with here, it's spare money. So now you are willing to be registered to Triple M. Do you understand? Triple M starts with 100 rand up to 100,000 for first dreams. So if you want, you have that 100 rand, you want to put it in, unfortunately you will not qualify for the $20 registration bonus. You only qualify with that if you have donated 1,000 rand or more. But that should not be a driving tool for people to force people to join with 1,000 rand. It's not a basic standard. The basic standard is 100 rand. We understand. So it's gonna be me just pushing my move, you know, pushing my hustle, wanting you to put more money, whereas I know I just want to get 100 rand. Because if you have put 500 rand, I get 50 rand for referral bonus. Whereas if I tell you to put in 1,000, I know I've got 100 rand. I mean, by cake, you can get by cake from 100 rand. So yes, the $20 you get if your dream is 1,000 rand,
and above. And then if it's a 10,000 rand, you get $50. And then if it's 100,000, you get $100. That is converted to rand when you withdraw. At the time of buying, it's around 258, and then by the time your dream, you draw a dream, sometimes you get 340 to 350, depending when did you withdraw your dream. And then other people who are greedy, they even, when you have done that 1,000 dream, and then you get credited that 300 rand, and then they tell you when you withdraw that 300 rand is there, because it's their registration, whatever fee. It's not, it's yours. Whatever that's in your PO, it's yours. No one should come back to you and say, just because I registered, then that one is my no, they're robbing you. So now, you are the person who has registered now. You've donated into the system, and now you feel you cannot keep this to yourself. You must tell your friend, you must tell your neighbor, tell your colleague, or whoever you want to tell. The system say thank you by giving you a referral bonus. For the first dream, that's one thing that we have to understand. For the first dream, it's a full 10%. Even now with the restart, those who have referrals, whom their referrals has put PH, they see it's a full 10% because we want the restart. But when the person now is putting in the second dream, they say old money minus new money. If this person has put in 10,000, you got 1,000 bonus, and then in the system, they withdrew 15,000. Now they want to put back 20,000. They will say 15,000 minus 20,000, and then they credit you for the balance that is there. Because remember, you've already gotten debt. Because it was growing with 30%. The 10,000 not growing with 30%. It's not the fault of the system that you actually withdrew it immediately. It becomes clean. But they take it as if this person has withdrawn 15,000, it means you took your withdrawal as 150. So that money, you are fully paid for it. So if this person now is putting 20,000, they'll say this 20 minus this 15, and then you are left with this 5. So that is where if your downline is putting more money, you start to question, why am I getting less bonus? It is because of that. So we must understand that also. We don't advise people to just join Triple M. You don't know how to attach yourself. You don't know how to write the letter of happiness. You can't write to support. Now you start to recruit. Who's gonna take care of this person if you yourself, no one, you can't take care of yourself. If, say, has recruited me, I am his responsibility. He must teach me the system. Not his guider. His guider is not there. He must teach me, take me through the system. Let me know before I introduce Mr. Mbewe to the system myself. Because now remember, if he introduces me, 2 days down the line, I take Mr. Mbewe, hey, let's go, there is this thing. I take him to you. When he has paid, you have to attach for him. You're losing your own datas. I'm getting my 10% as it is. You understand it? So that's where it comes. If I bring 4 people to you, and then you will register only one, all 3 you take them, and then tomorrow I receive a call. Hey, I took my downline to someone somewhere, but I cannot even see their bonus. What happened? I don't know. When you check the PO and then you see, no, these people, they under someone. No, she stole my people, I want my people. And then these people, they end up having 2 accounts and then being on moratorium. So it takes only 10 days and you will become a guider if you've done all your tasks, because all the tasks are being posted in the class. And unfortunately, he has passed, but he cannot do anyone's task, because immediately he opens his own laptop and he does your tasks. It sends the IP to Triple M. We understand that. It's gonna send an IP to Triple M that daddy has done 1, 2, 3. And you are happy when your tasks are green. Then come the results time. Now they check it. They didn't check before. Come the results time, they check everything. And then they see this is a duplication. Not because it's a duplicate. Your work is very different, but because of the IP. So that is why it's important, when you want to join the class, do everything yourself. Rather ask for mentorship. Let this person mentor you, but do everything yourself. If I recruit Mr. Mbewe as a referral, I'll get only 10%, right? If Mr. Mbewe introduces Lindiwe,
He will get 10%, I no longer get anything. Because I'm just it, a referral. If Lindy were introduced to brother, and then she will get 10%, he no longer gets anything, I no longer get anything. But if I am a guider, I introduce Mr. Mbewe, I will get 10% that I am his referral. Still get 5% that I'm his guider. Yes. And then he introduces Lindiwe. He will get the 10%, he's the referral. I will still get 5% that I am her guider. And then she introduces Ubrada. She will get 10%, I will still get 5%. So you see, to be a referral, it's nice. But it's even nicer to be a guider. Because you can have a string of 20 people. Their referral will just get that 10% because they introduced you. But all of them, you as a guider, you still get 5% of them. It's even nicer when you have these are guiders, all of them. There is Patricia, eh? Mr. Mewe is here as a guide. And then Daddy is there as a guide. They will have their own strings. Patricia there is gonna get 5% of whatever Daddy and Mr. Mewe is doing. Eh? But they, as now, they have their own structures now. Then they start to get their 5%. But from their structure, I will still get 3% that I don't have to work hard for. Because these people, they don't have to call me, I'm no longer their guide. They've got their guiders, these two. And then these ones, they mature. They mentor their own guiders. They have guiders under them. It's their guiders there. Ne? They will get those 5%. Ne? And then from them, I'll still get 3% because they are. But from their structure, I'll still get another percent. It says 1%. You get paid until then. We understand. You get paid until then, and then the hard work ends with them. Now I only have to answer his problems. But for his structure, he has to take care of them. Because with Triple M, you only learn when you attend to problems. Because if every time his structure has got a problem, he phones Patricia. When will he learn to attend to his queries? So we understand. So it's even nicer when you are a guider, you have guiders under your structure. Like me, I'm there, I've got 32 guiders that are direct. Those guiders, they've got their own structure of guiders, and then those other guiders, they've got people that are in class right now. So you see, we are soon coming there, because now we're there. So we are soon coming there. So that's where we need to be. This team, when we come back, we have to be, it shouldn't be daddy alone. It should be guiders. Women too. I didn't even know this team has women. Because only men call me from this team. So yes, we have to see women there. We have to drive the latest Maseratis. And then we say, man, Triple M is groomed. The best. Yes. And then we have to go and cruise. Remember now, you if you're not originally from South Africa, you left your home to look for better. So why must you go back home here, 800? You must see. You see? But unfortunately, it won't be the South African government that has given you the opportunity. It will be my broad, a Russian. So why don't you all go to Russia? As I've been telling you, I've got people in Ghana. So those people, they fall under East Africa. And East Africa, because they're still a small group, what do? They are using Bitcoins. Zimbabwean people, they're using Bitcoins. It is now that they started with Mukuru and Echo Cash. But the original ones, they started with Bitcoins. Or going to Congo, going to Nigeria, they are all still using Bitcoins because it is global. You can sell it anyway. Yes. So we just it's easier when you explain it as an EFT, because it's a money that stays in the computer. It's just that you have to, after you have it in your computer, you apply for the card. There are a lot of them, but the one that has been working successfully in South Africa is Sapo card. Yes. When you have your Sapo card, you can withdraw your money anyway. And now there are even institutions where the agents that can sell the houses for Bitcoins. If you have your Bitcoin, you'll be very safe. So that's just about it with the technicalities.
after the letter of the letter that got people confused, and then after that we can ask the question and then we explore the PO, because it's important that we enter the PO and just learn the basics of the PO. Thank you very much. I love you guys.